Batman is stuck at the zero point on Fortnite Island. Or is he? This is the Comic Storian channel where I take some of your favorite trade paperbacks and single issues and I break them down into digestible bites to help you understand. Then I read them dramatically back to you. All alterations to the panels, text, and images are to prevent copyright problems, and all art is owned by its respective companies. Today we're going to be looking at the final issue of Batman Fortnite. For those who don't know, Fortnite has an entirely deep and intensive lore behind it, and Batman has now been sucked onto the island. At first he couldn't remember who he was or what he was doing there, but after teaming up with Deathstroke and Catwoman, he's figured it all out and found a way home, only to be betrayed by Deathstroke at the last second. The link to each of the videos is down below, along with a link to our other channel where we did the lore of Fortnite. As the portal begins to shut down, Batman finally managed to process what just happened. Deathstroke trapped them at the zero point. There isn't enough power between him and Cat to power up the panel and get them back home. Deathstroke played them like amateurs, and he let it happen. Cat pulls out her whip, telling him that he's always worrying about the other, but don't give up yet. She may have missed grabbing him, but she did manage to snag his gadget, the one that synced the zero point with their home. Batman takes the device, holding it up, but the zero point only shows a portal going back to the loop, which doesn't help them at all. Except, maybe it does. Batman says that what they need is a third person who originates from their world. They thought that that was Deathstroke, but they did run into someone else who felt familiar. Catwoman asks, "The woman dressed up like a playing card? I got the same feeling. But what happens if we go back in and we lose our memories in the battlefield?" Batman ties himself to Cat's whip, stating that he doubts whoever made this would allow that to happen. "But it's a risk. I'll go first. If I seem confused, pull me back." He takes a deep breath walking through and remembers everything just fine. He calls to Cat that there's no memory loss, but if something happens to them over time, they have to hurry. She asks how are they supposed to find this Harlequin, and Batman attaches the anchor on Cat's whip onto his grappling gun, stating, "Aerial reconnaissance. Hold on." She wraps her arms around him, telling him anytime, and he fires the grappling hook, latching it onto the battle bus that brings all of the contestants in. The two scan the area, dangling from it. It doesn't take long for them to find Harley Quinn as she is shooting and maiming everyone in sight. Batman tells Cat that they tried to reason with her before. "Pointless. Strike hard and fast." The two quickly jump in, but the bleach-skinned woman seemingly dances around their hits. As Catwoman cracks her whip with one arm, Batman kicks the gun out of the other. She pulls on the whip, sending the woman to the ground, with Bat telling her that they need to figure out how to make her understand if they want her to get us back home. Harley Quinn sits up yelling, "Maybe you two are just stupid enough to figure out that I don't want to go home!" Catwoman stares for a moment and asks, "She can talk? How?" Harley tells them, "Duh, because I'm probably amazing like this island until you came back and won't shut up!" Bat tells her that they need to go home, but it'll take the three of them and their chances of that are rapidly diminishing. Harley thinks about it. "Oh, now I get it! You don't freaking listen!" She sweeps Batman's feet out from underneath him and begins to shoot, yelling, "I love it here! We get to fight and dress up and die and get up and do it all over again and look awesome doing it! The fighting, the flossing, the total bonkers craziness of the whole island! These are my people and I'm staying!" As Harley jumps in to hit Batman with her unicorn pick, Batman spins back, punching her in the face, finally knocking her out. Batman looks at the woman. "Our world must be very strange. I'd assumed she lost her memory too, but if she's in her right mind and wants to stay..." But before he could go on, something whizzes by his face, and when he looks over, he sees a metal blade, very similar to the ones that he uses. He quickly turns back to see another version of himself and Cat, along with another wave of contestants. Cat lunges at her counterpart, asking, "Who the hell are these guys?" And Bat fights, "Duplicates. That explains why we saw beings outside of the loop who are still in the loop. Seems the island creates a snapshot of those who escape." Cat tells him, "Sure, you can check out, but you can never really leave. Well, these two are as good as we are, and we're running out of time." Batman throws a flashbang, blinding everyone, telling Cat to open up the portal and get them out of here. The two stumble in with Harley, and they begin to get the machine back up and running. Once the zero point locks onto their original point of origin, Batman throws an explosive batarang into the control panel. "This'll make sure that we seal it from this side." He then goes and picks up Harley, but Catwoman tells him to wait. He looks at her and she says, "Maybe they should stay." Before Batman has a chance to respond, the two are kicked as Harley launches herself up, yelling, "That's what she said! By she, I mean me! You could talk amongst yourselves, but I'm missing out on all the sweet, sweet carnage!" Catwoman gets ready to take off after her, but Batman stops her, telling her, "We did all of this to get back home. What's changed?" Catwoman tells him, "She's scared." "Yeah, this place is strange, but we know how it works now. We've got autonomy, freedom. We've got each other. You saw those snapshot versions of us? We could be happy here." Batman asks, "You think that you wouldn't be happy back home?" And Catwoman tells him, "No, I don't know. Maybe we're enemies there, or strangers, or married to other people. When I first met you, I figured you'd just be another way to survive, to escape the loop, but now I don't want to lose what we have." Batman looks away.
I know what you mean. I'd be lying if I said that I didn't have similar thoughts. But I have a feeling that people are counting on me on the other side, that this dimensional breach is dangerous and could happen again. I have to stop it."
Catwoman asks, "Why you? Why do you have to go back?"
"I don't know. It just feels like it's who I am."
A few moments later, she takes his hand. "Yeah, that sounds about right. Let's go." The two begin to run, jumping through the portal just in time for the batarang on the other side to explode and shut the portal down. As they land, Kat says that it looks like it worked. But if this is home, why doesn't she remember? Just then, a flood of memories begin to pour into their minds and they just stare at each other. And after a few moments, Batman looks at her.
"Selina."
And Catwoman tells him, "No, I told you. We should have stayed." She swings away and Batman returns to the GCPD asking where's Deathstroke. But Jim tells him Gone escaped. But it doesn't matter now, they won. He did the important thing and closed that crack and no one got hurt. Batman doesn't respond for a moment and then says that he's not sure they won at all. Deathstroke couldn't have pulled this off without a backer, someone from this world. It had to be someone wealthy, powerful, and influential. And the likely candidates don't put his mind at ease. Meanwhile, over in a penthouse in Metropolis, Deathstroke says that the crack in Gotham is closed, but it doesn't matter. The anchor device that he planted at the zero point is coming in strong, which means Lex Luthor sits up in his chair. It means that the tethering worked. We have the ability to return to the zero point and make use of that power. Deathstroke tells him.
Exactly. And I gotta say, I had my doubts even Batman could do what we needed him to, but it worked perfectly.
Another twisted voice begins to laugh.
Don't give him too much credit. It's not hard to predict what Batman will do when you are Batman.
The Batman who laughs steps out, stating that they needed the world's greatest detective to unlock the secrets of this island. He needed an emotional engine to drive him, Catwoman. He knows a few things about other realities as well. They might say that all of this is right in his wheelhouse. Lex raises a glass.
We delivered as agreed, reached to the zero point, planted the anchor device so that we could return there. I'd say that the imagined order got everything it wanted, or do you prefer they?
Dr. Sloan steps out. Please, Mr. Luthor, they is what the island dwellers call it. I think that we're a little more civilized here. And yes, you've delivered precisely what you promised. Please accept my compliments. Lex tells her,
well, if that's the case, I'd say it's time for you to keep up your end of the bargain,
She smiles, looking out the window. We've already begun. And just above the Daily Planet, another tear begins to form, similar to what happened in Gotham. And there you guys have it, the conclusion to the Batman Fortnite adventure. Now, there's so many questions here, but before we get into any of the actual lore and what is going on, I just want to say, if you're a Fortnite fan who just happened to stumble across us, keep in mind, almost every day we cover Batman, Superman, and all of the comic books that exist in the world, along with various portions of video game lore and other things. If you like the content here, please consider sticking around or checking out the rest of our videos. We put a lot of time into them. But now let's talk about this video here. First off, the Batman Who Laughs is already back in comics. Man, that didn't take long, did it at all? Also, if you're wondering who Dr. Sloan is, that is the current villain in the Fortnite lore. And if you're wondering about the tear above Daily Planet, well, Superman is already announced to be the mid-season character for Fortnite. So that's probably what's gonna happen there. Whether or not it'll be a full comic, who knows? We'll find out soon though, won't we? But what did you guys think of this overall storyline? I'm not gonna lie, being a fan of Fortnite lore and being a fan of Batman and them doing this properly, I really enjoyed this whole thing. For me, the idea that we can tell a solid story in the world of Fortnite, promote Batman, promote Fortnite, promote everything, it was a really awesome idea and I really did enjoy it. But I know a lot of people don't like the fact that DC Comics has been working with Fortnite recently. So what is your opinion and why do you feel that way? Also, don't forget guys, check back frequently because we do a lot of comic book videos here. We'd love to have you around. Thank you so much and I'll see you next time right here at the Comic Story and Channel.